I recently tried out this new smart home device brand called Meross, and I think I found the best smart plug at the most affordable price. It works pretty well with its app, and it can simultaneously work together with Samsung Smartthings. Let's take a look at it now. Hi everyone, welcome to another Sky Perspective video. I've used this D-Link smart plug for more than 5 to 7 years now. It works, but it is an old model and it is super slow. Every time I turn on and off the switch from the app, it takes about 4 to 5 seconds before the switch reacts. And this D-Link smart plug does not integrate with any home automation systems like Google Home or Samsung Smartthings. Meet Meross, the smart plug that solves all these problems. I really like the design of this smart plug. Even the logo looks so cool, as it lights up the on-off button. I feel that somewhere within Meross manufacturing, there are good user experience designers who really design and think from the user's perspective. Turning on and off the switch using the app is insanely fast. I don't know how they do it. It's literally like flicking on and off the wall switch. There is no lag at all. And it's the same the other way around. I can press the physical switch on the smart plug, and the app will show its corresponding on and off status right away. Even when I disconnect from my home Wi-Fi to simulate the scenario when I'm outside, using my mobile data over internet, turning on and off the switch is still pretty fast. The setup process is pretty straightforward too. I installed the app and followed the steps on the app. For a start, the app turns on the Wi-Fi server on the smart plug and instructs me to connect my phone Wi-Fi to the smart plug Wi-Fi server. After that, the app takes over to do the rest of the other configurations. All I have to do is to tell it my home Wi-Fi network name and password. And after that, I can do this. In the individual switch menu, we get to check the power consumption, and it can even plot the consumption graphs for the past 1 week or 1 month. We can also do things like turn the LED light on and off. This is really handy when you are sleeping at night and you don't want to have a glow at the smart plug area. Once again, changing these settings is very fast. There is no lag at all. The connectivity app is pretty robust too. When I pulled out the smart plug and tap the icon on the app obviously won't be able to find it. It tries for a while and then it says time out, meaning it's going to stop looking for the smart plug. And when I plug it back in, it just works again. And that's like in less than 10 seconds. As for the Meross app, it's pretty intuitive too. We can set up the scenes and routines where multiple plugs can be switched on and off at different times of the day. For example, I want to turn off both switches at 10 p.m. every night at bedtime. I'll first create a scene called bedtime. The app has preset scenes like when we are having a party, when we are leaving the home, or at morning sunrise. In our case, we want to select this bedtime icon and then set it to turn both the switches off. The app has given the preset a name of goodnight, which I think I'm okay with that. Next, we will create a routine. Let's select a schedule routine and choose run the goodnight scene every day at 10 p.m. And there we go. Both switches will be turned off at 10 p.m. every night. From the couple of tests I've tried, they work pretty well. I've registered and linked this smart plug to my Meross account, and the good thing about that is that I can control the devices on both my tablet and my phone. Turning them on and off from any device will still keep all of their on and off status in sync across all devices. That is really impressive. Okay, next, we are moving on to a more complex setup, integrating this with Samsung Smartthings Hub, which you don't have to do if you want to just use the Meross app. Now, this is my whole entire smart home ecosystem right now. I started off with Philips Hue bulbs and switches. Then I bought Samsung Smartthings Hub. After that, IKEA smart bulbs and switches got so cheap and affordable, so I add them in. And now, I'm adding Meross smart plug. Adding this Meross smart plug to SmartThings is pretty simple too. I basically tell SmartThings I have an account with Meross, authorize SmartThings to run my device on my Meross account, and that's it. After that, I can control this Meross smart plug on my SmartThings dashboard straight away. And the Meross app still works by the side as well. This means I can control the smart plug using either the SmartThings app or the Meross app. And the best part is, I can use my IKEA smart switch to turn on and off my Meross smart plug, because they are both integrated with Samsung SmartThings. With a flick of the switch, I can turn on both my monitors and my computer speakers all at once. Over the last few months, my whole smart home ecosystem seems to be gravitating towards Samsung SmartThings as the main system. And the wonderful thing is, I just found out that Samsung has recently released their SmartThings app on Windows platform. This means I can control all my lights and switches directly from my PC. Just to let everyone know, this video is not sponsored, and I bought these Meross smart plugs on Amazon myself. In fact, I bought all the devices presented in this video using my own money. The only downside of this Meross smart plug is that it is too fat, which blocks the second power socket beside it. Well, this is easily solved by using a double plug. Oh, and before I forget, let's talk about its price. These are the price comparison comparing this Meross smart plug to other smart plugs I can get in Australia. And my choice is pretty obvious, as you can see. Hey everyone, I always leave the promotion of my channel at the end of the video, so you can get the main content fast. As my channel is nearing 1,000 subscribers, I want to take the opportunity to thank all of you who have supported my channel along the way. Very soon, the channel will be able to unlock YouTube features like Community tab, and I'm so looking forward to connecting more with all of you. 1 year ago, I started this channel just for fun, and didn't expect I could make it so far, sharing ideas with so many of you. Once again, I can't thank all of you enough for supporting my work. I hope I can share more relevant and useful content with all of you in future. Okay, that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and look after yourself, everyone. Bye!